I'm here with John Kanellopoulos. John, I look at a lot of corneas. I put fluorescein on. I see punctate keratopathy. Is that all that I need to know about epithelium?
It's always interesting in an anterior segment practice to be able to assess dry eye. And we're all familiar that our classic measurement standards, tear breakup time and Schirmer, are extremely subjective tests. We had the opportunity to piggyback on the tremendous work by Dan Reinstein on epithelial work with the OCT provided by OptiView. And basically, we're scanning everybody in our office the last year. So we have over 150,000 epithelial mapping scans. And we presented a couple papers at this year's Refractive Subspecialty Day, and we have several papers published within this last year. We're starting to use these scans to first diagnose dry eye and follow up dry eye treatment. We think that this epithelial monitoring, and this only addresses the central 6 millimeters of the cornea, is extremely insightful in following post refractive surgery patients. And there's two completely different patterns between PRK and LASIK. I should say three, because there's a third pattern between LASIK extra, LASIK eyes that have been prophylactically treated with cross-linking. I think that it has become in our practice a tremendous objective tool to assess dryness. But not only that, it has given us extreme insight in assessing these corneas topographically. It really opens a new dimension in how, if you have the epithelial map in hand, you read pentacam maps, you read placido disc imaging, and you read Cassini maps, which is a new multicolor spot reflection topography. So you can kind of see the limitation that each one of these devices has in regard to the significant epithelial changes that some of eyes have, but we have never been able to picture them objectively.
So what are the changes that you're seeing? What's a treatment X or pathology X reflects in epithelial pattern Y?
All right, great question. Let's go with practical things. You have a LASIK dry eye patient or a post-cataract surgery dry eye patient with problems with vision, fluctuation in vision. You see the eye is dry, and you're trying to assess how am I going to refract this patient? If I have to retreat, how am I going to retreat this patient? So you look at the topography, a pentacam, Cyanflug imaging, and then you look at the epithelium map and you see that this eye has significant epithelial irregularities. Now this will throw off the Cyanflug imaging. The dry and thicker parts of the epithelium, and this is thicknesses of over 10 microns. These are very significant thicknesses.
From an optical standpoint, too.
From an optical standpoint, too, because the epithelial index of refraction is 1.5 times that of stroma, and especially if it's irregular.
Right.
So it gives you great insight to be more cautious of reading these images and making clinical decisions based on them, as well as in a more simple way, being able to see if your dry eye treatment is working and whether this objective imaging correlates with the patient's statement of improvement, of non-improvement, et cetera.
Really, really interesting stuff, John. John, thank you very much for sharing this with us today.
Oh, sure. Thank you for having me.